Okay.
You did it?
Yeah. Oh. I did it.
Wait.
I'm not starting yet.
Okay, well.
I'm just getting prepared.
Okay.
Because it, you know, it ain't quite six yet. While we wait, you can go get yourself a nice hot cup of coffee or a refreshing beverage. Whatever you would like to do, because we're not officially starting till 6 o'clock. But for those of you who are clicking on early, basically this is a Friday night thing that I've been led to do to encourage and give you a little, just try to give you some praise and some prayer and passages to help encourage you in this wild, wild world we live in. And last week I had a couple of people send requests for songs they would like for me to sing that I don't know yet. So stay tuned for those kind of things in the upcoming weeks and months, because this is something that's going to continue after all of this takes place. What are you, my wife's wiggling her eyes. What's the matter?
Oh, I'm just trying to remember who all I was supposed to invite.
Oh. And maybe, I don't know, last week we had a visitor come to the door, and someone, Karen Barnes, reminded me that it was like Mr. Rogers. Ooh, someone's at the door.
Yeah,
who could
funny.
That be? I was hoping Mr. McFeely would come by, but I don't think he will. But yeah, anyway, we're going to do this every Friday night. We may move the day to Saturday night, I don't know, just as time goes by, but it's a lot of fun just to sit down and sing some songs and learn a little bit about the Lord and pray together and worship together in this way and do things that are encouraging and joyful. So let's see, where are we at? I've got about another minute and a half.
Yeah, I should be done by then.
I guess I could tune this thing while I wait. Is it six?
Straight up and down.
6 o'clock, straight up and down. Well, we started about 5 minutes early so that the wife could invite people to join that have been wanting to join us tonight. I'm going to try to make this, not last, you know, more than 30 minutes. I have a tendency to go over, and that's okay. I just kind of move as the Lord leads me. I've got three songs I'd like to sing with you tonight. I want to share a few verses out of the Gospel of John tonight. That's one of my favorite places to go, and it has a specific theme, and hopefully I'll be able to expound on that a little bit. But we, as always, I want to start with my mom's favorite ever gospel song, and it really is one of my favorites and some others too. And if you keep tuning in and joining with us, you're going to learn it. And I know there's other verses to it, other versions of it, but this is my particular version of it, and I hope you enjoy it, and sing along if you like. Hey, how about first, let's pray. I especially want to pray for, let me throw this out there. We have a member of our church who's been in the hospital for a few days and has gone through not one but three surgeries, and she's going to have a fourth one on Monday, and I know she covets your prayers. Her name's Emmy. Please be in prayer for Emmy. Be in prayer for this surgery. We hope that this is the last surgery she has to have to cure her issue. And please, just be in prayer for her. Add her to your prayers. And, you know, Jesus said we were we should pray and ought not faint when we do it. And Paul said to pray without ceasing. So let's continue to be in prayer for Sister Emmy. And Paul Rash, too. I've heard Paul Rash has been ill, possibly pneumonia. Just, you know, folks, people get sick. And when they do, we need to pray for them. And we need to ask God to heal their bodies. God loves for us to reach out to Him. We're His children. So let's pray for Emmy and Paul and pray, and we'll get started. And gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we love You. We thank You, Father God, for this beautiful day You've given us here where we're at. I don't know about other people, but what a gorgeous day it was. A great day for a walk. A great day to see the sunshine, God. Lots of vitamin D. Father, we thank You for all the joy You bring in our lives, for laughter and music and Your Word, and most of all, salvation, Father God. That is the greatest gift ever, and we just don't thank You enough for it, Father. We ought to be doing our happy dance right now for the salvation that comes through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. And Father, tonight we want to lift up to You Emmy and Paul. Lord, we pray that You would heal their bodies. Give them a touch of healing grace. Heal them from the top of their heads to the bottom of their feet, and give their families peace and understanding and wisdom through all of this. And Lord, we just want to give You praise. We want to see Your glory come. We pray, Father God, for a great revival in the church and a great awakening in the world. Lord, we love You, we thank You, and we wouldn't dare but pray these things other than in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, here we go. I'll fly away. Some glad morning when this life is over. Sing is actually an old hymn out of the Blue Hymn Book in the Baptist Hymnal. It's number 335, and I think there is a passage I want to share with you concerning that, other than the passages I already have for you. Now, if I can find it, I'll share it. If not, I won't. That's kind of how that works. Oh, yeah, here it is. This is, and I want to share with you this particular passage because this is something that Jesus was telling his disciples, and we are his disciples. And anytime we read the Bible, we need to understand that God is speaking to us right here, right now. That's how we need to comprehend it. Jesus told his disciples, "Let not your heart be troubled." Amen.
Amen.
Let not your heart be troubled. And that, you know, sometimes we take verses out of context. I know a friend of mine sent me a message this week saying, "Hey, check out this devotion for me. I want to make sure that the passage isn't out of context," and it wasn't. And sometimes we do that. But this particular passage is never ever out of context, no matter what the situation. Let not your heart be troubled. If you're someone who knows Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, there is no reason for your heart to ever be troubled. He says, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, you know, and the way, you know." Well, the way is, Jesus said, "I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and no man comes to the Father but by me." But what he's talking about, folks, is our heavenly home. And I can't stress this enough. We are going to get through all these things that burden our lives and are troublesome to our lives and nervous to our lives. And one day there's going to be a new heaven, there's going to be a new earth, and we are going to be with our Lord. We're going to be with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He's preparing a place for us in heaven. In fact, it's already there. It's really already done. But that is one of the great promises of Jesus Christ written right here in the Word of God. And I wanted to share that with you because the next song that I have for you is a really great song. And I've heard this song so many different ways. So I'm going to do it the way I do it. And it's called Standing on the Promises. It's hymn number 335. So if you'll turn in your hymnals to that, you'll be just fine. Against us shall prosper. That is a promise in the Bible. We are God's children. We are highly favored by God because we have this great, great salvation through Jesus Christ, and that ought to bring great, great joy to our hearts. And I hope you're looking for joy today and being joyful and trusting in the Lord and spending time in prayer and studying His Word. And gosh, going outside and looking at all the beautiful things. I mean, I don't know, it might be raining where you're at. If it is, take joy in that rain because God replenishes the earth. Take joy in whatever weather you have because that's the way God works. That's the way He makes the earth work. There's a passage in the Bible that I shared this week on Facebook, and it comes out of the book of Genesis. I'm going to share that with you real quick. And this was right after the flood. Man, where is it? There it is, I found it. Right after the flood, when God decided that every man's imagination on earth was just totally bound for wickedness and there was no changing their heart, and He decided to do a reset, and He set Noah out in the ark. After that was done, He said this to Noah, to the children of God, to all of us that read it. He said, "While the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, and summer and winter, and day and night shall not cease." Do you understand what that means? As long as this earth exists, there's going to be sun up and sun down and nighttime and daytime and seed time and harvest. We might have trouble. Jesus said, "In this world you'll have trouble, but be of good cheer. I've overcome the world." But God promised, as long as the world exists, things are going to be fine. Why? Because God's in control, not us. Just trust the Lord God Almighty today. So let me get to the passages that I wanted to share with you, with the theme that I want to share with you tonight. And that is the great theme of love.
You have a request.
I do.
Yes. Lisa Bernie Hicks would like you to sing "On the Wings of a Snow White Dove."
Well, she needs send that to me in a message because I don't have that one. I don't have that particular in my repertoire, but I'd like to learn it. I think that's a Hank Snow. Not real sure. But I'll check on that. Thank you, Lisa. I'll put that on my list. That makes three songs on my list now to learn. It's something you can do when you're on a voluntary house arrest. Not really. We're just trying to stay safe, folks. We don't want to give this disease any more room. In fact, we want to pray this disease out.
Amen.
I want to talk to you about love today. This is one of the things that I've really stuck on since I've started this whole journey with God and preaching. The whole Word of God really is love. Some folks look at certain parts of it and go, "Wow, God is, I can't believe He would do something like that or demand something like that." But God just really wants the best for His creation. And everything in the Bible, it's W.A. Criswell once said that Jesus Christ is the crimson thread that is woven throughout the Bible. And Jesus brought us love. It's the message of love. God is love. And if you read the whole Bible in context, you're going to see that He loves His creation, and He wants us to all have a proper relationship with Him again, like it was in the beginning. And this is why He has the plan that He has. But the passage that I have for you to start with comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 13. Now again, this is Jesus, and since we're so close, this Sunday is Palm Sunday, by the way, which is a week before Jesus' crucifixion, when He went to the cross for our sin. And right after Palm Sunday, He was having His last meal on earth with His closest friends. And he was all together with them having a supper. It's called the Last Supper, in fact. And he had done some wonderful things to teach them there, but he said something that we should never, ever, ever forget. He told His disciples, and you're His disciples too. He said, "A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples if you have love one to another. You know, I could preach that every Sunday. I could preach that every Sunday because that's what Jesus did for us. His love for us is what brings us closer to God. And that's what his command, this is a command for believers, to love one another. Loving one another means that we need to spend more time, especially right now, checking on people. You know, give somebody a phone call. Give somebody a text. Send somebody a message. Ask them how they're doing. Ask them if they need something prayed for, if they need praying. If you're young and able to do so, then ask them if they need something from the store. And you go wait in line for them and go get them something. Or maybe it's someone that needs counseling. Maybe somebody's nervous right now. And maybe you just read a passage in the scripture that you can share with them. And maybe, just maybe, you can get online on social media and start sharing encouraging passages. God's word does not return to him void. Just like John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Share that verse this week. People will get that. They will understand that because God's word is quick and powerful. And it does a lot of work. So please, love one another. That is a huge, huge commandment of God. Out of all the commandments we could have, love is it. He said the greatest commandment was to love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, and soul. And the second was like unto it, love your neighbor as yourself. And if you say you love God, then you got to love your neighbor. You got to love one another. So that's the passage I wanted to take you to. And it goes a little deeper than that. Because in the next couple of chapters, in chapter 15, Jesus makes a great example of what that love looks like. In chapter 15, verse 13, he says, greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. And that's exactly what Christ did. Jesus laid down his life for his friends. He's the one that knew. When he was teaching these words, he knew that in a few days he would be falsely arrested, falsely accused, mocked, spit on, taken to a gruesome crucifixion. But he laid his life down for his friends. He took all of the sin of the world on him. And he took that to the cross and he nailed it to the cross so that we could have right relationship with the Father. That is great love. That is our example. That, now, we don't have to go to the cross. Jesus already did that. But that's the kind of, the magnitude of the attitude. That is how we're supposed to love one another, just like Jesus loved us. I've often said, we need to pray this prayer. Lord, teach me to love people the way you do. Father, let me see people the way you see them. Love them like Christ loves them. You pray that prayer every day, and then maybe, just maybe, we won't be so angry sometimes. Maybe we won't be so bitter sometimes. Maybe we won't be so scared sometimes because we're loving like Jesus loves. And we know that that kind of love is godly love. Let me explain it further. In 1 John chapter 4, the same apostle that wrote what Jesus said back in the Gospel of John wrote these words. Again, he wrote them, but he was led by the Holy Spirit. This is God's words to us. He said in John chapter 4, verse 7, beloved, that's a huge word, beloved. Beloved's a great word. I have a pastor, evangelist friend that does a great work with orphans and other people. And I'm not sure how much I can really say, but Dr. Jeff uses this word a lot. Dr. Jeff uses this word a lot. Beloved. Dr. Jeff Johnson, one of my favorite men in the world. He is just a sweet man. One of the nicest men I've ever met. One of the most loving men I've ever met. He says beloved a lot. He calls his wife beloved. But here the apostle uses the word beloved for us. Beloved. It's a huge word meaning really, really loved. That's I don't know how to explain it anymore. Let us love one another. Let us love one another. This was his main message. If you ever read anything by John, which is the Gospel of John and 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, and Revelation, love is mentioned a lot. And he's the one that sat the closest to Jesus. He's the one that was leaning on Jesus in that picture in the Lord's Supper. He's the one that was sitting right there next to Christ. He's the one whom Jesus loved, the Bible tells us. He said, "Let us love one another, for love is of God." You can't say that God's not loving when the Bible says he is. His own word says he is. "For love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God." If you love, you are born again. You know God. If you truly love, and the kind of love that God talks about, this unconditional agape love, not the superficial love, not the kind of love that says, "I love chicken wings and I love baseball and I love my friends." No, this is an unconditional love, the kind of love that carries sin to the cross. "And love is born of God, and he that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loves not knoweth not God, for God is love." There it is right there. If you ever wanted to know what God is love. God is love. Again, unconditional love. "And this was manifested in the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son, Jesus, into the world, that we might live through him." That we would live through him. See, there's a big thing going on here. What he's telling us is God loved us so much that he sent his Son. Way back before he wrote this, he wrote this around 95 AD, but way back in the Gospel of John, that was that time. He loved us so much, Jesus went to the cross, and we live through him. We don't face the second death because of the salvation that Christ brings to those that believe in him. He sent his only Son into the world that we might live through him. Live. That's way better than just a life where you die and then you're gone into damnation forever. This is a never dying. Yes, the body dies, but the spirit goes on and is with the rest of the time in heaven with the Father, with Christ, at the Lord's feet, where there's no sunshine because all the sun comes from him, all the light comes from him. We live through him. Without him, we have no life. Without Christ, we have no life. Because without him, it's just over. It's futile without Christ. That we might live through him. Verse 10, "Herein is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sin." Herein is love, not that we loved God. You know, that's the funny thing. We're not searching after God. We didn't search after God. He came after us. And he came after us with Christ. He sent Jesus. 2,000-something years ago, he sent Jesus on the earth, and Jesus walked and preached the gospel, the good news, the love of God. He preached salvation. He brought that to the world. "Whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." He sent his Son to be the propitiation. Propitiation is a big fancy word, only used twice in the Bible, that means mercy. Mercy. Our sin separates us from God, but the mercy that Christ brings washes that sin away. That is love. "Beloved," there's that word again. I love it in this last verse, verse 11. "If God so loved us, we ought also to love one another." Do you see that? Do you understand that? If we spent more time loving one another, there would be less things to worry about. There'd be less things to fret over. If we followed that commandment to love one another, to not be stressful, to not be fearful, to not be troubled, to not be worried, even in times of trouble. If we're loving one another, if we're loving one another, we don't have those things to deal with. So that's the message I have for you tonight. Love one another. Through all this, love one another. another. God's word commands that we do so. And I can't think of a better way to live life than loving one another. So here's the last song I want to sing this evening. I sang it Wednesday night at Bible study. A lot of you probably know it. Probably know it by heart. I don't know anything by heart anymore. I can't even remember my own phone number. But that's okay. This last song is How Great Is Our God. And if you know it, sing along with me. And if not, just move your mouth in praise and worship. And God knows your heart. God knows your heart.
Pretty sure, Deb, I'm pretty sure he does not know. Will your anchor hold?
Nope, I don't. I'm going to sing this one more if I can find it, and then I'm going to pray us out, because I know that if you live here in Port Clinton, I heard of a really cool thing at 7 o'clock tonight. All of the all of the Port Clinton band members from the high school, no matter where they're at, are going to go out in their front yards, and they are going to start playing music at the advice of Mr. Miller to bring some really great, joyful things in town, and I agree with him. People are going to get out in their front yard, and they are going to play music, band music. He even mentioned pick up your guitar. He said if you were alumni or whatever. So there might be some really cool band music going on in Port Clinton today, and I look forward to hearing that. So this last song tonight is Old Rugged Cross, and this is for Carol McAnally. And I'm actually going to try to sing it in the right key, so let me wet my whistle one more time, and then we'll pray. Let me start with the chorus. Let's see, where is the chorus in this song?
Yeah.
pray with you and get out tonight. The sun is still shining where we're at. Of course, we're an hour ahead of some of y'all, 3 hours ahead of some of y'all. But get out tonight, enjoy some sunshine, and enjoy what God has to offer. Count the blessings in your life. Write them down on a piece of paper. Start with salvation. Just put 10 things down that God's blessed you with. Fold that up and put it in your pocket. And every time you start to get discouraged, take that out of your pocket and look at it. The first thing you're going to see is, God loves me so much, He sent His only begotten Son that He gave me salvation. And that's what I want to do right now before I pray us out of here. If there's anybody watching who's never accepted Christ as their Savior, oh, you might have gone to church. You might have attended church with your grandparents. You might even be a pastor's kid. You might even be a pastor. I've heard stories my whole life about pastors who preached at the pulpit for years and then one day finally accepted Christ as their Savior. I'm asking you to know the Lord. I'm just going to put it out there. The Bible says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with mouth confession is made unto salvation. But really, it's just as simple as this. Whosoever, Romans 10:13, whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. All you have to do is know that you need Him. Just repent of the sin that separates you from God. Know that Jesus washes that away because we can't do it on our own. And ask Him to be the Lord of your life. In fact, if you just pray with me right now, just pray. Lord, I know I'm a sinner. I know I'm separated from You. I know, Father, that I have no hope in the life to come without Jesus Christ. Lord, I just want to turn now from my sin. I can't do this on my own. I need help. I need the help of the Holy Spirit. So I just pray right now that Jesus, You would be the Lord of my life, that I accept salvation, that come into my life, God, come into my life, Lord, and let me follow You and be Your disciple. I believe in Jesus. I believe that You died for my sin, and I want You to be the Lord of my life. And I pray this in Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer, any form of that prayer where you accepted Christ, you are now in the kingdom of God. You're in the family of God. Jesus said you've got to be born again, and that's how that's done. You've got to be born in the Spirit. You've got to accept that free gift of salvation. If you've done that, let us know. Send us a note. Send us a message on our church website or our Facebook page and let us know that you've accepted Christ, because we will rejoice with you. All the angels in heaven rejoice over one sinner that repents. And I'm going to go ahead and close up and just remind you that we will be live again on Sunday at 11 o'clock for Palm Sunday. All of you regulars that go to church with us, we normally do Lord's Supper. We're going to do a virtual Lord's Supper, so get you together some bread and something there to drink, and we will go through this together and do the Lord's Supper in a social distance safe way. And we'll still celebrate the risen Christ, amen?
Amen.
We always want to celebrate the risen Christ, because we don't serve a dead God. We serve a living God,
amen.
A powerful God, a mighty God, a loving God.
Amen.
So join us Sunday, 11 o'clock, Facebook Live. And if you miss any of the messages, please check out our YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube and look up Lake Point Baptist Church, Port Clinton, Ohio. Find it, subscribe to it, and you can watch all of our past services or whatever else we upload there, because everything should be encouraging to you. Everything there should be leading you toward Christ or teaching you more about His Word, because that's our mission, is to teach people about Christ, teach people about God's Word, support our missionaries that are out there doing the work that we can't do, and loving our neighbor as ourselves, loving one another. That's our mission, loving God and loving others. And that's all I have for you tonight. I love you guys with all my heart, and I hope to see you again soon. Stay safe. And stay close to God. Amen.
Amen.